Mark Cuban directs Dallas Mavericks not to play national anthem before NBA games. For the first dozen or so games of the NBA season, Mark Cuban, Shark Tank man, billionaire investor, usually a pretty smart guy, told them, "We're not going to play the anthem at all." And you may be saying, well, this is kind of an old story. You know, the NBA intervened. They forced him to play. He said he shouldn't do it, whatever. No. Mark Cuban, let's not let the story get memory hold. Mark Cuban is the most outspoken progressive of all the NBA owners. He's the one who says, we're going to tank for Luka, and gets a fine, but says it. He's the one who comes out and says, I'm a little uncomfortable about China. Nobody else will actually say that. Mark Cuban is also a man in 2017 who came out and said, we are going to stand for the anthem. And everybody said, oh, okay, wow, wonderful. Well, four short years later, now he doesn't even play it, so people don't have to stand for it. My point is that you can't trust men. You can't trust humans. You can't trust people to keep their promises, because when it is politically or personally expedient for them to do, they will just discard them and hope you don't find their stories later on. Psalm 50. But to the wicked, God says, what right have you to recite my laws or take my covenant on your lips? When humans trust in other wicked humans to be their leaders, to be their examples, it's trusting wicked people who have no right to have things on their lips. Don't trust me. Don't trust Mark Cuban. Don't trust some TV preacher you see. All of us are wicked. It is the Word of God that's pure. It is the Word of God that never changes. It is its truth and purity that we need today. If you find someone to raise your flag for culture, for politics, for religion, whatever it is, chances are, as we've seen in the Christian and the secular world quite recently, chances are they will fail you. Chances are they are liars. Chances are they have a history or a past. What right do the wicked have to these things? Nothing. What right do we have in the Word? In the Word, its truth, its purity, that's the only thing that never changes. Don't follow humans, follow the Lord.